A big pleasure to be here in such a beautiful venue. And I'm very glad that I can talk to you about our very important and urgent research on microplastics in during pregnancy, exposure to microplastics during pregnancy. So why is it important? It's because baby in the womb represents really the most vulnerable period of human development. What happens in the womb really determines a very long-term health of the baby. And why is it urgent? It's because, as we know, the microplastics are now everywhere, but we really don't know what is the exposure to microplastic during pregnancy and what kind of consequences for maternal or fetal health they may have. So I would like to talk to you about a placenta today and why focusing on placenta is really important in this microplastic pollution world. So I think it's a shame because placenta is not very well known in general public. I think it's not a lot of people know what placenta is. So today I really would like to also give you a brief history of placenta. So placenta is this tremendous, amazing organ that develops during pregnancy. And it is crucial for both maternal and fetal health during pregnancy. Placenta actually brings nutrients and oxygen to the developing baby and also removes all the waste products from the baby and also functions as a temporary endocrine organ, producing a lot of different hormones that are essential for healthy pregnancy outcomes. So this might actually surprise you, but placenta is not of maternal origin. So all the men and women in this world had a placenta. So where does it actually come from? This is an image of blastocyst. So it's a fertilized egg at day 5 of pregnancy. And this little bundle of cells at the bottom, these are cells that will give rise to an embryo, to a baby. And the cells that surround that blastocyst, these are actually first placenta cells. So this blastocyst at 2 weeks of pregnancy, it actually implants itself into the uterus of the mother. And then these placenta cells start to grow very rapidly and divide. And they grow and they grow and they start to actually dig in through the uterus of the mother in order to get to the maternal blood supply. So there is one goal in mind for placenta right now, is to suck up as many nutrients as possible from the mother in order to support the developing baby. So after actually growing and growing, at around the third trimester of pregnancy, placenta becomes this very complex, big organ in the body. And at this stage, it is the size of a volleyball. And placenta is actually bathing in maternal blood at this stage. And as much as 25% of maternal blood actually flows through the placenta. So this is a real tremendous amount. And as we've heard from our speakers before, we now detect plastics in the blood. So let's just take a moment to think about that. So is there a problem if there are plastics in the blood or plastic in the placenta? And we cannot answer this question yet. This research is very, very new. But we can draw some conclusions on the research on air pollution particles. So air pollution particles come from dust, dirt, combustion, fossil fuels. And actually, our colleagues from Belgium, they discovered for the first time in 2019 that these particles are present in the placenta. And since then, there have been quite a lot of research going on, epidemiological research, connecting exposure to these air pollution particles with a lot of adverse pregnancy outcomes, such as premature delivery, pre-eclampsia, miscarriages, and even stillbirths. So, of course, these are not microplastics, but morphologically and size-wise, they are very, very similar to microplastics. So in our research, we really wanted to ask questions, can't microplastics also reach the placenta? can they do harm to the placenta? And can the chemicals associated with microplastic cause harm as well? So how we go about to study that? We actually can grow placenta in a petri dish. We use specific placenta cells for that, called BVO B30. And these placenta cells are representative of the two very important cell types, syncytial tropoblasts and cytotropoblasts. So these two placenta cell types are actually in direct contact with maternal blood. And this is where all the exchange of nutrients and oxygen takes place. So they're extremely, extremely important. And we can use these placenta cells to actually study uptake and toxicity of microplastics. So what we see in here is the placenta in a petri dish. We grow placenta to a tight barrier, and we expose them to different microplastics. And in this video, in this pink color or violet color, you can see a protein that is within a placenta cell. The dirty yellow color are the nucleuses of the cells, and the little beads, the fluorescent particles, are actually the 200 nanometer polystyrene beads. And I'll play this video for you. So what you can see is that these beads are actually taken up by the cells, and they're accumulating in the cells. And we've done this for other sizes of the particles, and what we notice that all of them has been uptaken in both of those important placenta cell types. Even particle of 10 micrometers, which is almost a half of a placenta cell in size. So we know they are uptaken, but are they actually also transported through that cell barrier? And the answer is yes. What we see in the labs is that the small particles are really easily and quickly transported through the cell barrier, whereas the bigger particle sizes actually more or less stay within the cell. So what that tells us is that we have not only accumulation of particles in the placenta cells, but they also can transport through the placenta and reach the developing baby. So we know now that they are transported and accumulated, but actually, is there any toxicity? And we cannot talk about particle toxicity without talking about the chemicals that are leaching out of these particles. So this is a very recent study that just came out, and they found out that there are more than 10,000 different chemicals associated with plastics. And what our preliminary results show, this is very, very fresh still, is that these chemicals that leach out to these placenta cells can actually disturb very important placenta function, the endocrine function. So we see that some genes responsible for production of estrogen and progesterone has been affected. And these two hormones are extremely important for maintenance of pregnancy. The dropping, for example, of progesterone causes premature delivery. So we can already see that these particles might have very similar effects to what we observe with air pollution particles. What I would like to finish off with is these two studies that are fresh from the press. They came out this year. And actually, these studies were the first one to detect plastic particles not only in the placenta, but also in the fetal feces, which means that these particles are actually transported through the placenta and reach the unborn baby. So this image that we are familiar with is actually not so far from the truth. We are learning more and more that these particles can actually enter the environment of developing baby. We still have plenty of questions what kind of health effects that might have. But the totality of evidence that I showed you here shows that there is cause of concern and an urgent need to address this. So luckily, there are projects that are being funded, and this problem is being recognized. And these are the two projects that you will probably hear more about today as well, Aurora and Momentum. And this project brings scientists from all around the world and expertise from all around the world, not only to learn about this problem that we are facing, but also to provide solutions such as roadmap for risk assessment or exposure prevention. So I would really love to thank the funding bodies that recognize that this is an important issue to study for supporting us. And I hope as a scientist, as a researcher, I can provide data sooner than later, hopefully, that can help policy regulations so we can really take care of the unborn child and of the future generations. Thank you.